I've never played that in front of people before. It's called the Ackerman Rag. I just wrote that. I just acquired this very expensive guitar, and it belonged to a guy named Nick Ackerman, who was the lead singer of a band called The Virgins. Anybody? Fucking amazing band. I didn't know about them until I found out about this guitar. I walked into a guitar shop in New York City. And there's this, any guitar freaks in the audience? Okay. I have like 25 fucking guitars, right? So, you know, I don't really need to acquire very many more guitars, but there's this one guitar called, it's a Gibson J200, and I've always wanted one from the 50s. They're really, really expensive. And they're like just these, the J stands for jumbo. They're like this big. And it was played by, this guy who's a hero of mine, Reverend Gary Davis, who was the teacher of my guitar teacher, right? So I walk into Rudy's Music, which is this guitar shop I've been going to since I was like, you know, 18 years old. And I walk in like a couple months ago, and like my eye goes right to the back of the room, and there's this like 1959 J200, this beautiful, huge guitar back there. And I'm just like, what the fuck is that? They're like, that's Nick Ackerman's J200. Nick, you know, put out one record and then he died tragically. He had, a couple of problems, the kind of problems a lot of rock musicians had. And he died very young. So they were selling this guitar for his estate. It was $9,100. I was like, I'm playing the guitar. It's like talking to me. And I was like, fuck, I can't buy this guitar. It's like too much money. So I, right after this, I had a therapy session. So I'm sitting with my therapist, and I'm like talking to my therapist about this guitar. And she's like in her 70s, right? She's like, she goes, Chris, don't you have 25 guitars? And I was like, yeah, but each guitar has its like own characteristics, you know? And it's like, she goes, no. I understand why you want the guitar. She's like, couldn't you trade one of your other guitars for that guitar? And I was like, so I walk out, like the second I'm in the elevator going down from the session, and I call up Gordon, the manager, and I'm like, Gordon, I can't stop thinking about that J200, can you do a trade? He goes, look, man, I mean, if it was our guitar, I'd do it in a second, but we're selling it for Nick's estate, you know, so like, we don't really own the guitar, so it makes it a lot more complicated. That means they would have to buy the guitars from me, and then it makes it complicated. So he goes, what do you got? So I'm like, well, I got a 1965 Fender Precision Bass. And he goes, oh, fuck you. Are you kidding me? You're making my life so complicated. And what else you got? Well, I got a 67 Trini Lopez. These are like rare, very cool guitars, vintage guitars. He's like, okay, bring them in. So I bring them in. Basically, like, you know, they traded the guitar, you know, like $1,500. But the guitar has this amazing case. By the time I walked out of there, I was like already writing the piece of music that I wrote for you, that I played for you just now. And I finished it in the cab. Actually, I was up all night that night. I just kept waking up and working on this piece of music, which is what I do all the time. I play guitar all night. If you're ever up at like 4 o'clock in the morning and you're like, just sort of like, it's lonely being up in the middle of the night. But just know, somewhere, I'm probably awake. Like playing the same five notes on guitar over and over again. And I'm here for you.